Hello scholars, how are you all? I hope you are enjoying your days with your family and parallelly doing your school work also. Are you doing that? Yes? So let's start our studies today with the topic division of money. Okay. Now, as the money comes, what concept comes to your mind is that you have already learned, I suppose, is 100 paisa is equal to 1 rupee and 1000 paisa will be equal to 10 rupee. This is the main thing you have to remember in the concept of division of money. Okay, so we will have our first example, that is rupees 810, 40 paisa divided by 20. Okay. When you have such type of question, where you have rupees and paisa, you can do two ways. You can solve this sum in two ways. That is the method one and the method two. Okay. We will see one method each and then we will decide which method we will follow the most. Okay. So in the first method, we will have the only dividend part. Okay. So, the dividend part is rupees 810 and 40 paisa. So, first of all, what I will do is, I will have 810 rupees broken into two part. That is 810 rupees alag se. Okay. Now, why I am doing this is, because see, the divisor is 20. Okay. So, 20 ke table mein, there will not be 810. There will be 800. Even numbers it will be. Okay, 10 will not be there in 20 because 10 is lesser than 20. Yes? So, I am breaking it down in such a manner that I can divide the rupees completely without a remainder. Okay. And then, this 10 rupees, I will convert it into paisa and add it to paisa section. Fine? See, likewise. Rupees 800 I have kept as it is and rupees 10 I have converted to 1000 paisa. You know, no? 10 rupees, see, here it is written. 1000 paisa is equal to 10 rupees. So, 10 rupees is equal to 1000 paisa plus 40 paisa. See, I have put the bracket. Okay, initially it was a bracket with 810. Now it is with paisa. Bracket is with paisa. Okay. Now, this will be 1040 paisa and this will be 800 rupees. Fine. So, we will have 800 rupees and 1040 paisa. Now, what I will do is, I will divide the rupees first with 20 and then divide the paisa with 20. Okay. This is the first method we go about. Fine. So, we will bring the divisor also. We have changed the dividend into our comfortable numbers wherein we will not have any remainder. Okay. So, now 800 divided by 20 plus 1040 divided by 20. Okay. Now, this is rupees and this is paisa. So, we will perform the division. That is, we have 20 ka table here and 800 is here. So, the first digit 8 is less, that's why 20 times 0 will give me 0 and 8 minus 0 is 8. And this middle wala 0 we will bring down, that is 80. Now, we will see 80 comes n 4 times in the table. So, 20 multiplied by 4 will give me 80. So, 20 multiplied by 4 will give me 80. So, my answer will be 0 and now this sum is over for me. Yes, is it over, students? No, because the second zero from the dividend is remaining. So I will bring the zero down and then 20 times zero will give me zero and my answer will be zero. Now the sum is over. Okay, so my answer is 40 here. So I will write 40, rupees 40 plus how many paisa? Let's find out. Okay, so we have the division of here again. 20 stable we have. Again, 1 is smaller than 20. So, 20 times 0 will give me 0. And 1 minus 0 will give me 1. This 0 I'll bring down. It's only 10 now. 10 is smaller than 20. So, again 0 times. Yes. And then 10 minus 0 will give me 10. Now, this 4 I will bring down. Okay. Now, it's 104. I have to find in the table now. 104 will be 20 times 5 will give me 100. So 20 times 5 will give me 100. Okay. Now 104 mein se 100 minus karna hai. So you will get the remainder as 4. Fine. Now this 0 I will bring it down. So I have 40 here. And you know 22s are 40. So 20 times 2 will give me 40. And the remainder is 0. So now you see you have the remainder 0. Okay. And my question is 52. Okay. So I'll write that in the table. That is 52 paisa here. Fine. Now I have 40 rupees and 52 paisa. That I can write it as like this. I'm removing the addition sign from between. Okay. So here I have the answer, that is rupees 40 and 52 paisa. And this is our first method. Okay. Now moving on to the second method, we will only take the dividend first. Fine. This is rupees and this is paisa. Now what I will do is, I will convert the whole of the rupees into paisa first. Okay. So 810 multiplied by 100. Yes. Because 100 paisa will give me 1 rupee. So I will multiply it by 100 paisa. And then addition of 40 paisa. See the signs in between. Multiplication and addition is there. Don't mess up here. Fine. So my answer will be 81,000 paisa and 40 paisa. Now this 810 rupees is converted into 81,000 paisa. Fine. As both are paisa of the same, you can say of the same category. So I will add them up and I will get 81,040 paisa. Fine. Now I will bring the divisor. Once I have changed the dividend into all paisa, I will bring the divisor, that is divide by 20. And now we will perform the division. Okay. So we will have our division 20 ka table. 8 is less than 0's are 0. 8 minus 0 is 8. And this 1 I will bring down. And 20, I think 4's are 80. Yes, 24 times 80. 81 minus 80 will give me 1. Okay, now this 0 I will bring it down. So I have 10. And 10 is smaller than 20. So 20 times 0 will give me 0. And 10 minus 0 is 10. And then 4 I will bring down. So 104 it is. Okay, let's check out 104 hai ya usse kam hai. We have 100, which is less than 104. So 20 times 5. 20 multiplied by 5 will give me 100. So 25 and minus 100. Okay, so 104 minus 100 will give me 4. Fine. Now my sum is over. Yes? No. I have to bring the 0 down. So I'll bring the 0 down. And 20 times 2 will give me 40. And I have the remainder as 0. Okay. So my answer is 4052. So here I will have the answer as 4052 and paisa. Don't forget this. Okay. Now I have paisa only. Now what I have to do is I have to convert this paisa into rupees. See, what we did first is, first we had rupees and paisa. Yes, then we combined them into paisa. We got the answer by division. And that division ka answer, we have to again split it up to the original state. Original state kya tha? Rupees and paisa wala state tha na? So we will change that. Okay, so now I will split this number as 4000 paisa and 52 paisa. Okay, now 4000 paisa, I know it will be what? 40 rupees. And 52 paisa we cannot convert into rupees. Because anyways 100 paisa chahiye 1 rupees banane ke liye. So we have only 52 paisa. So my answer will be 40 rupees and 52 paisa. Right. Now in both the method you get the same answer. But your path is different. Okay. In the first method what we do? We divide each number. That is, we divide rupees into by 20 and we divide paisa by 20 and then we get the answer. And in the second method, what we do is we convert the rupees into paisa and then we get the answer and then again we convert paisa into rupees. Fine. So students, I find that the second method is more convenient and in our sums, we will mostly use the second method. Okay. Fine, let's move on then. Now, again, you have to remember this. This is your thumb rule. Okay, don't forget this. And we will have the word problems. Okay, the cost of a pack of 5 pence is rupees 50 and 25 paisa. What is the cost of 1 pen? So, 1 pen ka cost dhoondna hai. So, it is the sum of division. Yes, and we have the solution. That is, number of pen is 5 and the rupees of 5 pence together is 50 paisa. And 50 rupees and 25 paisa. Yes. So, see student, it's 50 and 5. So, likewise only I come to know ke one pen will be at least 10 rupees. 10 rupees se zyada hoga. Because 50 hai. So, 5 tens are 50. So, 10 rupees se zyada hoga. 25 paisa we have to just divide among the 5. Okay. And then 5s are 25. So, my answer will be 10 rupees and 5 paisa. Without any division I can say that. Yes. So, now we will perform the division like 50 rupees we will change into paisa. The second method, as I said, we will change all the rupees into paisa. We will divide and then we will get the answer. And that answer we will again have in the previous form, that is into rupees and paisa. Okay. So, it will be 5000 plus 25 paisa and my dividend will be 5025 paisa. And I have to divide it by 5. Yes, to find the cost of 1 pen. So, we will have the division part. And 5 ka table you already know. So, 5 times 1 will give me 5. 5 minus 5 is 0. And then bringing the 0 down. 5 times 0 will give me 0. This 0 you are bringing down. Okay. And the digit when you bring it down, when it doesn't goes into the table, you have to put 0 as your quotient. Yes, this you already know. Fine. And then I'll have 0 here. I bring 2 down. And 2 is lesser than 5 again. So 5 times 0 will give me 0. And 2 minus 0 is 2. And I'll bring this 5 down. And I will have 5 times 5 will give me 25. So answer, the remainder is 0. And my question, that is, it is 1005. Okay. And that's paisa. Okay. Don't forget to write paisa here. Now I have paisa. What I will do now? What's the original form? Original form is rupees and paisa. So I'll change this paisa into rupees and paisa. So I'll bifurcate them. 1000 paisa and 5 paisa. And this 1000 paisa is how many rupees? It's 10 rupees. Yes. And 5 paisa will not change into rupees. Okay. And so my answer is rupees 10, 5 paisa. So each pen will be 10 rupees and 5 paisa. And my answer statement is the cost of 1 pen is 10 rupees and 5 paisa. Okay. Now the second sum. Ravi brought 3 identical notebook. Identical means same type of. Same notebooks for rupees 46 and 50 paisa. Okay. And how much did each notebook cost him? Yahan pe kya hai? Each. You remember, no? Each hota hai toh, you have to find out for division sum. Yes. And the solution we have, number of the books were 3 and the total cost were rupees 46.50 paisa. And to find out the cost of one book, we have to divide them. Yes. So first of all, we will change the dividend, that is paisa. And rupees into only paisa. Okay. That is 46 multiplied by 100 paisa. And this 50 paisa will be added. Fine. Now 46,000 plus 50 paisa will give me 46,050 paisa. Okay. Now once I have found out the dividend, I'll bring the divisor. Which is the divisor? It is 3 identical notebook. No. So 3 is my divisor. So, I will have cost of one notebook is equal to 4,650 divided by 3. And here we go with the division. Now, you already know the table of 3. Yes. So, how many times 3 goes in 4? It goes one time. So, 3 ones are 3. And 4 minus 3 will give me 1. 6 will be carried down. And 16 I have. How many times you require 3 to find out 16? 16 is not exactly divisible, yes? So I can say 3, 5 times will give me 15 and 1 will be the remainder, and I will bring this 5 down. Again it's 15, so 3 5s are 15 and 0, and my sum is over. Yes? No, this 0 is pending, no? So what I'll do, I'll write 0 in the quotient. Yes, I'll bring it down, and 3 times 0 will give me 0. And here we finish the sum. If you want to delete this last step, you can do that, students. Just don't forget to write the 0 in the quotient. Okay. Now the answer is 1550 paisa. Now I have to change this paisa into the real form, which is rupees and paisa. So I will divide this into 1500 paisa and 50 paisa. And this 1500 paisa will be how many rupees? Yes, it will be 15 rupees and then 50 paisa. So the cost of one book will be 15 rupees 50 paisa. Okay. And here we have the answer statement as the cost of one notebook is 15 rupees 50 paisa. Yes, clear with it? Now it's your Tufani time. And I remember, students, in the first video of the division, I have asked you one riddle type of question. And I told you that I'll give you the answer later on. So here we go. Okay, a man is 25 years old but has only had 6 birthdays. How can it be possible, yaar? 24 years old ho gaya, phir bhi only 6 birthdays he has. And I can say that by dividing 24 divided by 6, I get 4. I know that 6 4s are 24. So what comes to my mind is the concept of leap year. Yes, you know what is leap year? After every 4 years, you have 29th February being celebrated. Every year it is only 28th February. So I think that this man will be having his birthday on 29th February, and that's why it's happening. So see, let's calculate. The man is born, then 1 birthday, 2 birthday, 3 birthday and 4th wala birthday. Then again 4 years he'll have, after 4 years he'll have 1 birthday. After 4 years he'll have 1 birthday. That is 29th February will come. And likewise, he will have only 6 birthdays in the whole 25-year-old cycle. Okay. So his birthday is on 29th February. Fine. And I hope you are doing your homework on time and you are coming along with me as the videos are going. So for today, you have to complete your exercise number 4.6.